just those little things of being in a small state and having people be able to follow you makes it all worthwhile.
To say that I'm gonna be from Delaware, I'm gonna keep saying that for the rest of my life.
When we go and do really well, it makes them realize a small state can produce big things.
I feel like Delaware is it's a good state to be because it's small and you can get everything at once.
You come home, it's just relaxing. I like to sit on the couch, let the wind blow through the windows, across the cornfield. I just love living down here.
So you can imagine I have a lot of Delaware pride, proud to be from it, and I get to taste all parts of it.
I run into somebody that followed me in high school and in college. And that's pretty special, and that just, you know, speaks to how tight-knit group that the state of Delaware is.
He was our assistant coach for my senior year.
Great player, great person, deserves everything that's came his way.
See, this over here, they used to have all the sports, like all the athletes and whatnot, everything they've done, like newspaper articles, everything, like you'd see it here. It's pretty neat.
How many times were you up there?
A few times, I guess. That's what I liked about the school. I mean, they gave a lot of, I guess we should be quiet, but they gave a lot of support to, like, everybody in here, like the teachers, the faculty, the students, like no matter what sport you were in, if it was in the paper or something, if it was on the loudspeaker, the kids knew what was going on. So like you'd get some recognition and stuff. It was kind of nice. You know, where I'm from, there's so many alumni. So I mean, they're always asking how we're doing. And to be part of it, I guess, it's something else. I mean, because you always hear about the Delaware guys and how they're doing, but for them to come up and ask you how you're doing, it's weird. It's something I'm not used to, I guess, but I mean, couldn't be happier.
Every day in the summer they'd come out and we'd either give them lessons or we would just have fun going out and playing golf with them or interacting, if you will.
To be honest with you, when I moved out here, I had no idea that I was actually going to be playing like any serious golf, I guess. Ricky back there was the one who convinced all of us that we should start playing in tournaments, so we were like, oh, why not? I mean, might as well. And then I realized how much I like competing and whatnot. It's cool to see that people from Camden, Delaware, from Dover, Delaware, are doing stuff, and to put them at University of Delaware kind of just keeps them local so we can keep an eye on them.
It's pretty cool to watch a kid grow up from 6 years old to a young man like he is now in college and become the successful golfer that he is. He's a great player, but he's a better person than he is player.
Wow, that's nice. So,
he's a good kid.
I mean, I know it's an individual sport and all, and I'm trying to help make sure that my score is just helping the team. It's not an individual. It's not an individual thing. And like they all the guys up here kind of just they know I like to be kind of down to earth, but they like to exploit me. It's kind of like one of the things to get at me here. So, and I think the guys up at school have figured that out too. So, you know, it kind of comes from my dad. He always told me that, you know, there's always another shot. You're gonna make mistakes. Try to be like nonchalant about it, but I mean, thank you. But where was I? You know, I hit a lot of bad shots, and I am accepting of that, but I mean, like, it's gonna happen. Whatever happens, happens. That's always been the thing he's always told me. And I always find myself catching myself say that on the course. You know, I'll hit one in the pond and be like, you know what? Get it back on the next hole or something. You know what? I've always tried to keep, like, you know, focused on, like, the next shot, the next shot, the next shot, and then try to forget all the bad ones. And you know what? They've added up to be some decent scores, I guess. To say that I'm going to be from Delaware, I'm going to keep saying that for the rest of my life. I'm Dover, Delaware, Camden, Delaware, wherever I'm from now. But to be able to play golf here, to grow up here, to see all the kids I've met here, it's been a good time, and I'm hoping that it stays that way for the next 4 years. I mean, I don't know where I'm going to go, but Delaware's always home, I guess.
As a junior and senior in high school, I didn't really know what I wanted in college. I just kind of wanted to go away and see different parts of the country. And I went far away, about 8 hours, and then I was there for a year. And about halfway through that year, I was like, wow, I really don't like it here. I kind of want to be closer to home, where I can come home on the weekends if I need to. I love Delaware. I love the state. I love being here. And I think just being able to wear the shirts and wear the uniforms, it like makes me happy. And people are like, oh, Delaware, is that in New York? Like, some people don't even know it's a state. And like, when we go and do really well, it makes them realize like a small state can produce like big things. Hey, Mr. Bullock. Hey, good, how are you?
Oh, it's good to see you.
Yeah, sorry, this is like unexpected. This is my band director, Mr. Bullock. I go to UD now, and yeah. I'm on the rowing team. I was actually signed up for band up there my sophomore year, and then a girl was like, you'd be really good at it. So I kind of skipped out on band. And,
right.
Yeah. So it was great, and I love it.
Wow.
I got the Outstanding Soccer Player for 2007. So that was great. Hey! Good.
How's it going?
Yeah.
How's life?
Great. This is I think you're the girls' soccer coach now.
Boys.
Yeah. No, this is where I went to high school, and I miss it a lot. I have like so many great memories here, and some of my friends that I met, like, I still hang out with them now all the time. I did not row in high school. Nobody down here really knows that I even row, basically, and they don't even know what it is. I could tell somebody, and they're like, oh, rowing, and that's what I usually do. When the girl came to me about rowing, I was like, wow, college athletics, like, that's what I need to be doing. Delaware is special, personally to me, because it's home. You know, there's nothing like driving through the back roads of Southern Delaware and like with your music blaring and nobody can hear you, windows down, and like your hair is just going everywhere, and just going through the back roads and, you know, missing the beach traffic because you know the back roads, and especially from where I'm from, the towns and the communities, just like being so close together and everybody's always so nice. And I just think Delaware's special because I just love Delaware. I love it. I think it's great. And people always say they want to get out after high school, but I actually came back.
Tell them how you started here.
Oh, yeah.
One of the best.
My little run.
And left.
Trying.
Where did you end up on the scoring list? Second?
I'm not even sure.
First?
I want to say
there,
first.
Right? And your ball around?
No.
There? Oh, no ball?
I'm upset about that. Somebody got to handle that.
Wow.
I was looking at that because it's only three people. Never do
well,
it. You got
opinion,
me?
You were the best that ever played here.
Thank you. Delaware isn't represented as some big old grand school, but we have to make it that. And every time we get on the court, we know that and we feel that. We know we're always underrated. We know people say we're gonna lose, but like last year, we went farther than anybody could have ever thought. So that's just one of the perks of being a small school. They still have to get my ball in here. I think I was the second leading scorer of all time. I think I may have beat out Gina and Dan. But Ashima, I think she still holds the record. She still comes. Actually, every year we get together around Christmas and we have like a Del Castle reunion basketball game all the time. And Ashima comes, Gina comes, and our coach Tom comes, and it's a lot of fun. So this is a Voltech school, which means you can take up a trade. I actually took up nursing and I did CNA nursing And we actually left the building and went to another building that was specifically for nurses. And it was pretty cool because all of my friends were nurses and we all did everything together. You basically had the same classes because you had to work around the schedule of going over to this other school. But being a nurse was really fun. That was a really good experience because in my senior year, you can co-op, which is basically you go to school for about 2 hours and then leave and then go to your job. I thought I was a comedian of the class. Sometimes I got in trouble, just a little, but it never distracted my work. I will say that I got very good grades, and that's something that I, you know, try to keep up in college. And this is actually the ball of my 2009 year that we all signed, everybody that was on the team. As you can see, I tried to be the smart one and sign where I knew the ball would be facing so everybody could see me. Being in Delaware is fun. Being that it's so small, you know a lot of people. Everybody knows everybody. And it's cool because actually this year I got an email from a teacher in my at my elementary school. And she said, "Hey, Jaquetta, we've seen you playing on TV. All the students seen you." And they actually sent me 30 pictures of drawings that the like first graders and second graders, they drew of me with my jersey number and the number 3 on there. And that's like the aspect of being in a small area and, like you said, a community, because those same people still see you and still keep up with you, even from like my first grade. Like my first grade teacher contacted me, was like, "Wow, I didn't even know you still knew my name, but thank you." But just those little things of being in a small state and having people be able to follow you makes it all worthwhile.
Play clock's running low.
How's it feel to be back?
Good. I like helping out. It's fun. Makes me miss it a little bit, but it's not too bad.
You're
pretty
good, huh?
So I'm all right. I'm all right. I know what I'm doing out here. Still remember all these plays from running them a million times. This is the board that I'm on right here. Right here, second team all conference. Sorry. Yeah. That little guy. We'll go 121 waggle, backside post. All right, look for a backside post. If it's not there, then look for a tight end.
Wait, all right. So do you imagine running regular post corner?
Yeah, you're running regular post corner.
121 waggle, everybody. Zip.
Oh, no. Oh, Lord.
Good luck, Jake. Good luck, Jake.
Yeah.
My boy, Jamez.
Yeah. Jake.
No, Jake did actually.
But he taught me, coach.
This is Coach Wells. He coached me when I was here. Best coach I ever had. 4 years. Proud of him for letting me play. And I'll let him talk.
I don't know about let me play. I've been a fool not to play. Tremendous athlete. One of the most fierce competitors I've ever coached. He took us to 3 conference championships, 3 state finals in football. He did great things on the baseball team also. Took him to a state finals there. Just a winner all the way around. You can't teach that competitive spirit. He just has it naturally. So we miss him. He comes back, he pays it forward, as we talk about, to our young kids. And my son's up here as a freshman quarterback. If he can play anything close to what DJ has played for us, we'll be all right. So we still watch him play baseball. We're excited about this upcoming season, too.
This is where I played shortstop for 4 straight years. Senior year, we finally were able to get over the hump, made it to the state championship game. It's pretty cool. My senior year, I played short. My brother played third. It was really cool to get to play with him and especially play beside of him. I wanted to be close to home. I knew it would be a short trip for my parents to come watch me play. And I knew some like people that followed me when I played down here could be able to come up and see me play. So I wanted to play for them, hopefully make them proud. Sussex County is the best because it's 20 minutes from the beach. It's all farmland, there's no traffic, and everybody knows everybody. That's the best part. Get you in trouble at times, but everybody knows everybody. biggest thing that I like about living down here is my family is allowed to have horses. We have horses. My aunt and uncle have horses. We've had race horses since I was a little kid, so we've always been going to the horse races. Come home, it's just relaxing. I like to sit on the couch, let the wind blow through the windows, across the cornfield. It's just, I just love living down here. I just want to be a teacher, you know, teach, maybe work with kids with special needs, coach football and baseball, maybe run some baseball camps around here and help out in the area with kids that want to get better at baseball. And I've been helping with the football camps at the high school, so I'll help work those and hopefully get a head coaching job in baseball or football. So.
But you want to stay here?
Got to stay in Sussex County. Love Sussex County. Always. What, you going to break us down? You got us?
Hey, be quiet. Be quiet.
Let's go. Ready? Hey, good work today, fellas. Take a knee on Coach Wells. Hard work on three. One, two, three.
Hard work!
Yeah, over the summer, I'm a Rehoboth Beach lifeguard, and it's really probably one of the coolest jobs. You know, you get to see people from all over the state, especially people I played lacrosse with past in high school. And then there's people I've had from like New Mexico, California, you know, come and just have a great time, because one of the boardwalk is voted, I think, number four best boardwalk in the nation. So now we're on the infamous Rehoboth Boardwalk, where, you know, people all around the state and even around the East Coast all come to, because it's kind of a big deal, you know. Every night, you come here around 8 o'clock every night, it's just packed with people everywhere. Funland is definitely one of the most important parts of the boardwalk, especially little kids. I can just remember coming here every summer, being 10 years old, and always just begging your parents for tickets to go to Funland. So many great spots like Skee Ball, and of course the Haunted Mansion. And then you always have to go inside, going to Sea Dragon and the Chaos Machine. So it's really the stuff, you know, people love to do, and it's always crowded, especially on nights. So I can always just remember going here as a kid and loving it. And I still go once a year just for the heck of it. One of the biggest things people eat down here is definitely the pizza. And, you know, there's so many different kinds, so many different places, but also so many snacks and ice cream. Ice cream is probably one of the biggest, too. You'll get, like, Italian food. There's, like, Russian places. Because down here, there's really a lot of diversity. I kind of like the smaller community and stuff, and it's just kind of Delaware. A lot of people, you just know a lot of people, and just everyone in Delaware knows about Rehoboth Beach and Dewey Beach. Really, like, a memorable place right here. It's pretty historic. Just think about all the people who've been through here and the thousands and thousands of people come through here every day. So it's kind of cool to think about being a part of this and being a part of working for the city of Rehoboth, and especially just being on the beach every day. I feel like it's just like a great honor to, you know, just wear this Delaware stuff and be from Delaware. It's always been a dream of mine to like play for Delaware, because both my parents are alumni, and I don't know, I've just always grown up around the University of Delaware atmosphere. And then, you know, when I decided I wanted to play lacrosse there, it was a real big deal. Because Delaware, University of Delaware, you know, on the team, not too many Delaware kids who are on there. So it's kind of really sort of honored just to, you know, be part of that tradition and be able to, like, say, go home during, like, spring break and Christmas break and just say, you know, talk about how you're playing Division I lacrosse for a great team like University of Delaware. I was wearing a Delaware lacrosse shirt, and a kid from Ohio was just talking about how he wanted to go to University of Delaware and talk to me about lacrosse. And you can tell when you wear your stuff, people, you know, they glare at you because they know it's kind of a big deal. I think one of the unique things about me is I get all taste of Delaware because I'm from the capital, Dover, which is Kent County, and then I go to school in Newark, in Newcastle, and then during the summer I live down in Rehoboth. So it's kind of cool, I taste all atmosphere. Like down in Rehoboth, I get, you know, the beach life, lifeguarding and stuff, and then in Dover, it's like my high school, so I know a lot of hometown people, people I just grew up with. And then Newark, a lot of kids I met from lacrosse team and a lot of new people who go up there. So you can imagine I have a lot of Delaware pride. Proud to be from it, and I get to taste all parts of it too.
I don't know how to get a
Where do we go? Just up here. We used to, like for indoor track when it snowed, we used to run around the hallways
And it was really dangerous because you had to make all these really sharp turns. So it was like we'd run around the back part and then we'd come through here really quickly. And one time a guy like ran into a water fountain and the whole thing fell out of the wall. Yeah, we did sprints up and down this hallway. I remember that. I think the floor was all carpet.
Well, it's definitely important to me to stay in Delaware because it's just a nice state. You get a little bit of everything. Like when you come down here, there's like this small town and then there's fields 5 minutes away and then you go to Dover 10 minutes from here and it's like kind of a bustling city. I mean, not like most people would think of a bustling city, but like someone like me would think of a bustling city. And then you can go up north to Wilmington and Newark, which are bigger cities. And so I feel like Delaware is it's a good state to be because it's small and you can get everything at once. I was in band. I don't know if you guys knew that about me. I played trumpet 5th grade through junior year, and then senior year I switched over to baritone horn. So, yeah.
I really encouraged Katie to go anywhere she wanted, and she picked New York City and Delaware. Between the two, I really did hope she'd go to Delaware because, of course, I wanted her to be closer to home. But I wanted her to take advantage of her interests, and really, at Delaware, she can do that. There's so much there, and there's so much quality there. It's nice to have her close to home. It's nice to know that she's had her choice. She's changed her major a couple of times, as my son did, too. I always feel good that they're getting an excellent education.
I've had friends go really far away, and I don't think it's been as good for them. That means it's noon.
Oh, is that what it means?
Oh yeah, here it is. Cross country, 2007 was me and Kurt Reed, and 2009 was me and Paul Tonkin. So this is a dirt road. It's kind of paved now, not really dirt anymore. But it used to just be dusty, really loose dirt that was hard to run in. So when you like make the loop around the field, you come up on this tree line and you just cut over to the road. And it's about a half mile to where the course starts in the woods. So it's just like an exposed half mile in the sun. Wind, whatever, you can see every single person who's running faster than you, or no one if you're in front. That's always a nice feeling. Yeah, this is the most mentally challenging part of the course because it's just open. You're just running out there by yourself. As a runner, we get individual accolades, but really we're running as a team representing Delaware, representing all the students at Delaware and the athletes. And it's nice to say that like you're winning something for the state of Delaware, for the school, the University of Delaware, but also for the state because it's the biggest university here, so we represent.
Delaware is a small state, the first state. There's a lot of pride in the state. So there's a lot of pride in the small towns, and there's a lot of pride at UD. To go from all that tradition here in Smyrna to all the tradition at UD was a nice transition. It's nice that it's important there too, as much as it is here at home.
Paul was good to see Paul grow up. You know, it was funny. You know, he's always been my little brother, right? But I remember the day that he was more considered just my younger brother than my little brother. You know, you see him start as this little guy, you know, on the peewee football, and you can start to see some talent brewing, and then you see him in high school. You know, you see it, you know, you read about him on D preps. You know, it's been fun to see him go through what he's gone through, but you know, it's also been I don't know, it justifies everything that our parents have instilled in us and brought us up to be.
It's been a great 4 years. You know, the biggest thing is just all the different people I've met. I got a chance to play with for a lot of different coaches, you know, position coaches. I had two different ones that, I mean, I love both of them. And then I met so many different people from all over the U.S., you know, and people that really became my best friends. Towards the end of the first season out there, you know, I stayed in contact with Coach Rapone because it was a place I always wanted to come to. You know, before I even went out there, I wanted to come here. So, but me going out there was just to give myself more options, you know, to choose from. I wasn't positive I was going to come here, and then once I was out there, I just really thought about it, and it made the most sense. I could come back here. You know, all my friends were here, my mom here, I could see all my brothers, and it was a good fit.
I remember we went out there they changed the positions on you, got redshirted, and it just didn't fit. It made sense, and you came back home. And, you know, we weren't going to say anything. I know Dad wasn't going to say anything, but I think, you know, in the back of our minds, we all really kind of wished and hoped that he would come back home, and he did. And look what you were able to do.
We're here at the English Language Institute where my mom works. She's worked here for probably, I think, over 10 years. This is where she teaches, this is where her office is, and we're gonna go up there and we're gonna surprise her right now.
All right. Holly!
Hello.
Hi, honey.
Hi.
How are you?
Good.
Good to see you.
Well, we were thrilled. We were thrilled to get Paul back to Delaware. I think Delaware is where Paul always wanted to start out. And we missed him out in Kansas. So when he made the decision to, give up a couple of good scholarship offers out there and to come back, we were, 100% behind him, fully supportive. We, I think we threw a party. So we were very, very happy to get Paul back.
It makes it easy to go to school here. It's a different experience than anyone on the team gets to have. I have all my friends from high school that I can still see. We grab food every now and then, we meet up, and then I have all my friends on the team. So it's a unique situation, unlike a lot of the guys I know. And it makes it really special. Over 4 years, I got to experience that. One of the best parts about growing up in Delaware is, everyone always jokes around how small Delaware is, and everybody knows somebody that knows someone. Playing football in Delaware, there's a lot of people that follow me, and all the time I can go to the YMCA and someone that I don't know is like, my son plays at St. Mary Magdalene now. We watch you all the time. Or, I go to the mall, get something to eat, and I'll run into somebody that followed me in high school and in college. So, and that's pretty special. And that just, speaks to how tight-knit group that the state of Delaware is.
You can't help but feel a sense of pride when you see, Paul out there at that national level. We've also seen how hard Paul has worked. He's worked very, very hard to get to where he is. It's just really nice to see him as a role model. A lot of my friends have young sons who played in the same football program that Paul did, like a Pop Warner growing up. And the kids just look up to Paul, and that makes me feel good.
Got them. If you guys see this, I'm gonna hang them up. Thank you. I love these. It's awesome.
Nice. That's what it's all about.
I got two older brothers, so two great guys to look up to. I imitate both of them. Him musically, he's a genius on the piano, a wizard. So that's something I always, attempted to do. He tries to teach me, and my other brother played football in college. So the best mix I could possibly have. And then I have a little brother who I know tends to look up to me. So that makes, that pushes me to be a good role model.
You've got four brothers all within 8 years of each other. We're not the guys to be, very, very emotional with each other. And I think that's because we all have this understanding between the four of us that, we're all connected, right? And we all grew up so close to each other that, I don't think I would have, traded anything that we've had for any other type of life. Mom and Dad did a great job, bringing us up, and watching Paul come through, with all of us has been it's just been a great experience.
I remember when Paul decided to go out to Kansas, and your Nana said, I give it 6 months and he'll be home. Because Paul is just, he always has been a homebody. He often told my husband and I, well, Mom and Dad, when you grow up, you can move back to the small house that we moved out of, and I'll live in this house, because I'm never moving out of Delaware. He just, Delaware's in his blood. He loves it. He loves the people. He loves the area. And I think it's just a real strong sense of security. It's a safe place. It's a good place with good people. So your Nana was right. You were back in 6 months.
She's always right.
She's always right.
That was a good fit for me. I kind of grew up here. It's a comfort thing. Everyone always says that. You go to the school that
feels most like home, and well, it just happens this kind of is my home, so that wasn't a big decision. I used to come up here all the time, you know, getting out of middle school, fourth through sixth grade, I don't feel good. My mom would take me to class with her. I'd sit there and, you know, we'd go to the Five and Dime after class, walk down Main Street. So, you know, this kind of was my home growing up. It was just another place I spent my childhood, and that just made it a really easy decision.
To be able to play golf here, to grow up here, to see all the kids I've met here, it's been a good time, and I'm hoping that it stays that way for the next 4 years. I mean, I don't know where I'm going to go, but Delaware's always home.
And, you know, everyone always says that, you know, you go to the school that feels most like home, and well, it just happens this kind of is my home up. It was just another place I spent my childhood, and that just made it a really easy decision.
I love Delaware. I love the state. I love being here. I think just being able to wear the shirts and wear the uniforms, it like makes me happy.
And I knew some like people that followed me when I played down here could be able to come up and see me play. So I wanted to play for them, hopefully make them proud.
As a runner, we get individual accolades, but really we're running as a team representing Delaware, representing all the students at Delaware and the athletes. And it's nice to say that like you're winning something for the state of Delaware, for the school, the University of Delaware, but also for the state.
Delaware isn't represented as some big old grand school, but we have to make it that. That's just one of the perks of being a small school.
I feel like it's just like a great honor to wear this Delaware stuff and be from Delaware. It's always been a dream of mine to like play for Delaware.
Nina Rizal, golf, Camden.
Bethany Calloway, rowing, Seaford.
Jaquetta May, basketball, Wilmington.
DJ Long, baseball, Millsboro.
Katie Deinert, cross country and track, Smyrna.
Matt Matsko, lacrosse, Camden.
Paul Warlow, football, Wilmington, and I am Delaware.
I am Delaware.
We are Delaware.
I am Delaware.
I am Delaware.
We are Delaware.
I am Delaware.
We are Delaware.